Hi everyone, welcome back to Learn to Play. My name is Julie, and for those of you that are new here, welcome. I am a home daycare provider. In today's video, I'm going to go over our March calendar. I'm also going to do a mini grocery haul. I'm going to show you how I make my weekly menu on Canva. That is something I get asked quite often. I'm also going to show you changes that we've made as far as our schedule now that there are three of us, and just how we're storing things and like our preschool change up that we are now doing. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, here is my March desktop calendar. So what I'm going to be doing is I am going to be transferring this classroom calendar onto this and then making any kind of like notes that I need for myself that I don't want on this. This is what I post on the daycare Facebook page. This is the calendar that I keep posted at the daycare. So I don't want, you know, a bunch of scribble on this as well. I simply, instead of like writing out National Barbie Day, I just kind of put the symbols on here. And that way, hopefully they're self-explanatory, perhaps they're not, but to me they are. So I guess in the end, as long as I know what's going on, that's all that matters. So let's see here. Why did I put this Dr. Seuss Day as Tuesday? I want to say it's Monday. Oh Lordy, let me double check my calendar here. Because now I am second guessing myself. Darn it. Let me see, and I published this calendar on the Facebook page Friday. So let's see. Dr. Seuss. I know it's like the whole week is Dr. Seuss Day. Oh, it is Tuesday, March 2nd. Okay. So change of plans, I guess, for daycare, for our curriculum. This month in March, we are doing dinosaurs. I did go ahead and purchase the Mother Goose dinosaur curriculum for this month. I think this was their January curriculum, I want to say. And at first I was hesitant. I really didn't want to do dinosaurs for a whole month, but you know what? I have a lot going on right now. I needed a basic curriculum I can just build off of instead of doing my own. So we're doing Mother Goose curriculum this month. So here is Dr. Seuss Day. I had everything planned, and I'm going to show you how I've changed up my little planning for Monday. So I'll just switch it over. No big deal. We are doing green eggs and ham for lunch. So I'm going to have to thank God I did not print out my menu. I wanted to show you guys how I do my menu. I get asked so many questions about the menu. So I'm going to show you that from start to finish. National Barbie Day is the 9th. I'm going to insert a picture here, what we did last year. I bought this a wardrobe box from Home Depot and created a life-size Barbie box. I thought this turned out so cute. I was so in love with it. But I don't want to do the same thing this year. So I need to figure out something to do for National Barbie Day. I do give all the kids a Barbie that day. I simply just get them from the Dollar Tree. And then they do like some kind of like Barbie craft. But I want some kind of backdrops. I need to figure that out. On the 10th is National Pack a Lunch Day. So this really just pertains to kind of our menu that week. We serve them lunch in brown paper bags. The kids think it's funny. So we're going to do that. The 11th is Johnny Appleseed Day. I found some really cute crafts and stuff like that on Pinterest to do with this. So I'm really excited about that. So I will show you what I've come up with that. And then the 12th is National Plant a Flower Day. So I need to get little pots. I need to get flowers. And what we do is we do the seeded flower, and that way we keep them in the windows, and over like the next month we just kind of watch them grow. The children water their own flowers, and then either on Easter or Mother's Day we send home the flowers. So I need to get pots and flour and dirt for that. They will paint the pots. Let's see, obviously the 17th is St. Patty's Day. We will do a party that day. I will send home a special snack that day with them as well. I usually put like Lucky Charm cereal inside little baggies. So we'll get that stuff together. The 23rd is National Chip and Dip Day. So we will have that again. This is more for like a snack. So we'll do that. The 25th is Waffle Day. I think we'll probably have that actually for lunch, just because all the kids are here then at lunchtime. And then the 31st is National Crayon Day.
I think this year I'm going to try to like melt crayons for their Christmas gifts. I got them. I found a lady on like the Facebook Marketplace who does crayons, like melted crayons, and I got their name spelled out. That turned out really cute. I think she charged, it was like $1 or $1.50 a crayon per letter. So I'm going to maybe attempt to do our own melted crayons. That could be like a science experiment with the older ones. So we'll see how that goes. I do have two birthdays this month. I have a birthday on the 20th and I have a birthday on the 28th. So I think what we'll do, maybe we'll do both birthdays on the 24th. We'll combine them. So that will work out. It's so weird, guys, planning for March, because this is the time last year, I think I was only open for those first 2 weeks and then COVID shut us down and I was closed in for 3 months. So it's kind of like, I don't know. I feel kind of like, I don't want to jinx things. Like I know that governor probably isn't going to shut us down again, but I didn't think last year we would be shut down. So it's definitely bittersweet planning this March because I just had so many ideas for last year that weren't able to come to life. And other than that, I'm not off any days this month. I don't think we have like any official days off. What else? The Johnny Appleseed. I need to get apples for that because we'll do like apple painting. This chip and dip and the waffles will just put into our weekly menu. That won't be a big deal. And like I said, we're doing dinosaurs this month. All right, that is that for the calendar. Now let me show you our food menu for the month. Okay, first of all, this is the menu from last week. I simply have just created this template in Canva. I used to do this in Word, I think like Word 10 on my other computer, but the other computer is always dying. I have never purchased Word for this Mac computer and I really need to. I'm just too cheap. So I kind of just finagled it and scanned it and brought it over to Canva. So I definitely need to switch this out because we are going into the week of March. So these little things right here, I just find little like clip art and put it on here. And then let me switch this over. March week one. I'll probably change up the color even though green is for March. We'll just make it a lighter green. And then let me see, maybe I can put like, what's the first? Oh, Dr. Seuss. Okay, let me look. I think I did have a Dr. Seuss little template on here. As you can see, I was doing all these like little dinosaur things. I do have Canva Pro. I think it's like $13 a month, but it's worth the investment because I use it for so many things. All right, let's see if Dr. Seuss is even in here. He might not be. I don't think so. You know what? We're just going to leave it. I don't care. We're going to leave it blank. No one sees this but me anyways. I do post this on the Facebook page, but I doubt those parents even pay attention. So here is what my sister, this is what she's like jotted down. I am going to insert the grocery haul right now. And I did spend $66.81 on the grocery haul. Okay, so here is the grocery haul for next week for the daycares. We got these little rolls. We're going to be doing Sloppy Joe's, some egg noodles. We ran out of cheese, so I got a thing of cheese. I got a thing of eggs. We're going to do green eggs and ham on Monday to celebrate Dr. Seuss Day. Right now, I only got one thing of milk. I do need two, but for room in the refrigerator, I only got one. Got some yogurt for breakfast. The kids absolutely love this maple brown sugar oatmeal, so I got that. A thing of cinnamon bites. And then since this month it is St. Patrick's Day, I just got this big box right now of Lucky Charms. We probably won't do anything with that next week, but I just got it for now. A thing of grapes, some of these mini peppers. The kids love those with dip. I got this berry medley to go with the yogurt for breakfast one morning. This meat I got for meatloaf. My sister wants to make a meatloaf this week. I got a thing of fish sticks. Here is the honey ham to go with the green eggs and ham. I have a thing of dill pickles and then a can of pears, a can of peaches. I got a big thing of goldfish this time for, again, Dr. Seuss Day on Monday. We're going to do some activities and then I'm going to send home some goldfish snacks with them that day. And then for snack Monday, I'm going to do these little snap pretzels with this white chocolate, and I couldn't find green M&Ms, so I need to go to the store and get green M&Ms. I got a thing of rice, and then last but not least, a thing of green beans. As you can see, I had green eggs and ham on this Monday. I need to switch that over. Let's see here. What am I going to do? Monday, I'm not going to do eggs. Let's do French toast with sausage and milk. And then, let me see, what are we going to do for lunch? Oh, okay. She had fish sticks down. And then what else? Tater tots and apples and milk for lunch. I'm going to make that a little bit bigger here. Let's see. And then for snack, she has like these cheese crackers. And I put juice. It's either water or juice. Kind of just depends on our mood. Tuesday, she did have oatmeal. So now what we're going to do then for lunch, since this is Dr. Seuss Day, we are going to do green eggs. And actually, we're going to be doing like deviled eggs and then just dyeing the yolk green. Ham. And what else are we going to do? She put garlic bread. I'm not going to put that. I will put toast because originally she was going to do pizza bagels. And that's it. That's what we're going to have for lunch. And then for our snack, we will do goldfish. We're going to read them the One Fish, Two Fish book. So we'll do goldfish for snack. Wednesday, she put down pancakes. So let's switch this out. Oops, if I can spell here. And then I'll probably do some kind of fruit. I'm not sure yet. I'll just put it as fruit. Lunch, she's going to do grilled cheese, and then she's going to do chicken soup. And then we'll do crackers, obviously, and milk. And then she did have grapes. I'll probably just put grapes there instead of the crackers. All right, grapes for snack. We have trail mix. Okay, Thursday, I'm going to do the yogurt and fruit that you saw from the grocery haul. And then for lunch, she's going to do meatloaf. We haven't served the kids meatloaf in a long time. I'm hoping that they will eat it. We're not going to give them potatoes because they really don't eat mashed potatoes. They love rice. So we are giving them rice, green beans, and then I'll put peaches. Again, I want to make this a little bit bigger. Gosh, this is like not even lined up. It's so hard to get them to all look good. And then let's see. For snack, we'll do granola bar. Friday, she has them doing cereal. And I'll just keep that with a banana. And then she's going to do Sloppy Joes, which I don't know if we've ever given the kids Sloppy Joes before. Sloppy Joes, she wants to do pickles. I don't know. What else can we put with this? Sloppy Joes, pickles. We'll do pears. And then maybe we'll do like peas. All right, so that is that. And then as you can see, we had cheese crackers last week. So for snack on Friday, I think I'll do wafers with pudding. They seem to like that. The trail mix wasn't a huge hit. I don't know if I want to do that again, but I have that whole bag and I spent like $7 on it. So I think we are going to try trail mix again and see if they will eat it. Okay, so here is the menu. That portion is done. I'll simply print it out. I'll post it on the Facebook page and then I'll put it on my bulletin board. The next thing I want to show you how I am revamping what we are doing as far as organization for the three of us here at the daycare. Okay, so I bought these containers from Walmart. I think they were $6.98 for a 3-pack, so there's 4 containers. I actually need to go back today and get myself 2 more because I'm gonna be putting them on the shelf over there for my stuff. So these 2 right now are for Holly and Mandy. So the top shelf, I figured they can just have whatever weekly materials they need in here. They can keep in here. With that Mother Goose curriculum, it does come with a family newsletter each week. So that would be something I could put in here, and then Holly could put it in her 4 children's bins. So at the end of the day, on Monday, we could send them home. So again, just extra stuff up there. And then I broke it down Monday through Friday for their groups. So Monday, seeing I thought it was Dr. Seuss Day, I have nothing in there. And then, so I broke it down per day of all their art materials and everything like that in each of these. So I think that'll work out well. There is only one teacher guidebook with that Mother Goose, so I'll just simply keep it on top of one of their bins. We have decided to switch. Mandy's going to do the preschool 2, pre-K in the morning, and Holly's going to switch to the afternoon. So given that Mandy will do it first, I would put it on her bin. And then I found this really cute Jake Travels Back in Time book at the Dollar Tree. I figured they could read that. I think this curriculum does come with a book this week as well. Now, what I've changed is, since Mandy has the older group, I've given her different things for the children to do. Like, for instance, for that Dr. Seuss Day. I mean, I guess Holly could use this with the younger ones. This is like a stacking cup. They can see how many cups they can stack up. You put a piece of like cardstock in between. And then I have Legos. This is like a sorting, so they would do a pattern between red and white Legos. So I figure, since she does have the older group, this is too advanced for the two-year-olds to do something like that. And then she has all the same art projects, but what I've done with her is given her more things, you know, again, for older kids. Like, they're doing these dinosaur halves, they're doing letter tracing, number tracing. Let me see here if I have another one. So yeah, so I'm giving her like these letter tracing. Again, the two-year-olds, this is too, like, they're not ready for this. So I will plan accordingly each week. I will give her certain, you know, things to do. I'm gonna give Holly certain things to do. And then for me, I do table time upstairs. So what I've been doing is, while they're downstairs, so say Mandy's in preschool, Holly is in the gym area, then I would have a group up here doing table time. Now, I do table time with all three groups, both toddlers and the babies, but I wanted to start implementing actual activities for them to do up here, not just give them puzzles or crayons or something like that. This basically would go with both groups, I want to say, even though it could be a little, I don't know, not as advanced for the older group. But I made this for Dr. Seuss Day. I will give them goldfish, and we will cut out the goldfish and put it inside. I did like 6 different colors of this. I have laminated this, like, D is for dinosaur. Instead of them using bingo markers up here, I'll give them like pom-poms or something. They can use like tongs and practice fine motor skills. That will be one day. I only have each group for 30 minutes. This is definitely one for the younger kids. I have this pack of dinosaurs, so I simply will just have them match, you know, color match up here. I made these really cute like dinosaur scenes off of that Canva, and I just laminated it. And then I went to the Dollar Tree and bought each kid their own little set of dinosaurs, and so they can just play with that on the play mat. That would be another fun activity for them to do up here during table time. So I know it seems like a lot. I'm planning 3 different activities a week for all 3 of us, but again, the 2 age groups are so defined that the younger toddlers simply aren't ready to do what the older toddlers are doing. And then when they're with me, I want them to do something different as well. So it's fine. I mean, it is what it is, and I like creating stuff. I like doing curriculum. So I think that is gonna wrap up this video. Again, I just wanted to go over our month with you. I wanted to show you how I do the menus, and then give you a little bit of an update how I'm breaking down the way that we are teaching preschool and pre-preschool and whatever we're teaching over here. I hope you got some use out of this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you are not a subscriber, please consider doing so. And don't forget, the Learn to Play box is available. Please check out learntoplaybox.com. You can check us out on Facebook. You can send us an email if you have any questions about it. Next week, I am going to be doing an unboxing of the Learn to Play box, so I'm very excited about that. And yeah, I hope everyone has a great week, and I'll see you in my next video.